How will you experience your physical life when you have met this challenge of facing inward and living by the directives of your spiritual self? You will still chop wood and carry water, as the ancient Zen proverb tells us. You will not suddenly develop totally new talents or interests. However, you will have a level of awareness that lets you see things that have been hidden. Here are some of the insights that will give you a sense of peace and inner fulfillment. You will experience and enhance the meaningfulness of coincidences. You will become aware that there are no accidents in this intelligent system. You realize that everything that shows up in your life has something to teach you. You appreciate everyone and everything in your life. You are unable to entertain any doubts about the universal source of energy. You know that all beings are a part of it and receive sustenance from it. You are convinced that all weakness and falsehood come from a refusal to know this. You will feel loved. You will call for and accept divine guidance. This vital spiritual nourishment is felt in both your inner and outer experiences. Immobilizing fear diminishes as you feel the presence of the divine energy within you. All seems as it should be, even though you may not understand it. Your desires to right wrongs and fix the broken parts of your life are also part of this divine plan. You pursue your desires to serve God and humanity with clarity and peace. By focusing your inner energy on the beauty that surrounds you, you will receive that energy from your surroundings. With practice, this kind of receptiveness will become a source of strength and sustenance in your daily life. You will sense that anything that is destructive to one human is destructive to all. This higher awareness will lead you to the conclusion that Mahatma Gandhi came to, that God has no religion. That awareness will give you a loving energy that will help to bring all of us together. You will make a new agreement with reality. When your soul becomes the guiding force in your life, you will break the ordinary agreement with reality intellectually and physically. Your level of awareness will shift so dramatically that you will no longer feel bound by the agreement that defines reality for most others. You will experience surrender and acceptance. You will finally stop fighting and simply let go. You will accept that God knows what she is doing. This surrendering process will make you more effective in your sacred quest. You will become a waking dreamer. Everything that you are capable of achieving while dreaming will be possible while awake. The power of your mind to manifest what previously could only occur in sleeping dreams will begin to be your awakened reality. Some people take a lifetime to learn how to become a waking dreamer, to literally be in a dream state while awake. With your heightened awareness and the guidance of your higher self, you will become one of those waking dreamers. You will know the power and ecstasy of silence. As Herman Melville wrote, "Silence is the only voice of our God. All profound things and emotions of things are preceded and attended by silence." You will know that there is a spiritual solution to every problem. Problems such as addictions to drugs, foods, and alcohol have solutions in your higher self. By going within, you will see your excessive desires for something outside of yourself as an inadequate refuge for worldly pain. When you begin to achieve the highest levels of pleasure and euphoria by facing inward, the desire and the need for externals will simply disappear. Every problem, be it with relationships, finances, health, or self-image, has a solution in the sacred self. When you are peaceful, experience silence, meditate, and listen, really listen to God, you will be directed away from the worldly and toward the divinity that is within you. You will know what you need to do. You will shift from acquiring to sharing. You will desire less and yet feel more fulfilled. You will shift your attention away from yourself and take pleasure in serving others. You will live authentically. You will accept yourself, knowing that whatever behaviors you exhibited in the past, even the ones that may have been destructive and immoral, were a part of who you were at the time, and they had great lessons built into them for you to transcend. You will be able to say with conviction, "I am what I am." While some of the people who are close to you may find this difficult to accept, you will no longer be able to compromise yourself. You will be less judgmental and more forgiving. You will begin seeing that judging others does not define them, it defines you. Consequently, you will be less inclined to judge anyone or anything. You will also begin to forgive yourself. You will see mistakes as lessons for you to transcend. This will free you from the tyranny of self-recrimination. You have made the decision to be free.